Hello students, so today finally I'll explain this chapter, The Adventure of the Blue Carbuncle. Okay, so I gave you the introduction already and today I will just make a quick revision what we have discussed in this chapter in explanation. Okay, so page number one, there is a description only about the meeting of Sherlock Holmes and Watson. I think you guys have watched that video. See, if you have not heard that video, if you have not heard that explanation that I had made of 1.5 page, more than one page explanation has been done. So please watch that, hear that. Otherwise, because I am not going to repeat all. Okay, I will just give you the revision. So it's better for you that you just watch that video first. Okay, so what we had discussed in this chapter, that in this chapter there is a particular case that Sherlock Holmes has to solve. Okay, and we had discussed that Sherlock Holmes and Watson, there's a meeting of Sherlock Holmes and Watson, Dr. Watson. Okay, Dr. Watson arrives Sherlock Holmes' house and he notices that what he has been doing, he is engaged with the two items and he is investigating some case. Okay, so all about this we have discussed already. So we had reached till here that two items that okay, so two items that were being investigated by Sherlock Holmes were a hat and a goose. Okay, I told you this, and I told you also this, that how this hat came to Holmes. Okay, from where did he get this hat? And from where did he get this goose? Okay, so I told you that from Peterson. Peterson is a man who is a commissioner. So from Peterson, Sherlock Holmes got this hat. Okay, and goose. Okay, and how did Peterson get this these items? I told you that on the next page it is given. Okay. So some of the rough men attacked on a tallish man who was having a goose and a hat, but when Peterson goes and tries to defend that tallish man, okay, so what happened when they all notice that Peterson is approaching near them, so they all run away, they all took to their heels. I told you that, na? So till here we have discussed already, so I'll continue after that. What happened here, see, so now when Peterson finds that for your convenience I have marked some headings wonderfully. For your convenience you can watch. See, on this page what we will discuss, how does the hat come to Holmes, isme yahi discussion hai. On this page we will discuss about how does the hat come to Holmes. To Holmes ke paas kaise aayi thi, Peterson ke paas kaise aayi thi, aapko bataya maine. Okay, that's all. अब होता क्या है, when Peterson gets this hat and goose, Peterson decided कि उसको इस hat को वापस कर देना चाहिए. Peterson wanted to give the goose back to the owner but faced quite a problem. Mrs. Henry Baker was painted on a small cat that was tied to the goose left leg. Also, see, I cannot read all lines because it will take much time. So I am just giving you a quick summary. Okay, but I will not skip anything. Don't worry for that. I will give you each and everything of the chapter. Okay, so what happened now? तो Peterson जब देखता है कि ये जो goose है इसको वापस कर देना चाहिए, जिसको जो भी छोड़ के गया है. बट होता क्या है, वो देखता है goose के जो goose का जो left leg है उस पर एक एक small card है. उस पर क्या लिखा हुआ है, it was printed Mrs. Henry Baker. But he was confused because there were thousands of bakers in the city. So वो किस तरीके से उसको वापस करता. So what did he decide? He decided that Peterson thought that I am not able to find, there are lots of Henry Baker, so how can I give this hat back to the owner. Okay, so he decides then ki I should I should give these two items to Sherlock Holmes because he knows that Sherlock Holmes is expert in these things. Means if I will give these items to Sherlock Holmes, so definitely he will find the owner who belongs to this hat, who belongs to this keys. Okay, so that's why Peterson decided that I should hand them over to Sherlock Holmes. So that's why means in this way Sherlock Holmes is able to have these two items. Okay, so we have covered till here. Now what happens? See, okay, so what happens here? So ye sab kon bata raha hai? These all things are told to Dr. Watson by Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes ye sab bata rahe hain Dr. Watson ko ki kis tarike se Peterson ne unko ye do cheeze leke di hai. Okay, so what happened now? So you know that we are discussing just about hat, okay, and we didn't discuss and no description of goose till now is given. So what happens? The goose we kept until this morning, when it seemed to be going bad, Peterson will have it cooked today. I thought that I'd keep the hat with me. Means Sherlock Holmes says that मुझे लगा कि ये जो hat है मुझे अपने पास रखना चाहिए और ये जो goose है ना ये मैंने Peterson को वापस कर दिया. और Peterson ने क्या किया होगा, इस goose का पका के खा गया होगा. Means he had just cooked the goose for his dinner. Got it? In his dinner. So he will have it cooked today. उसने तो पका भी दिया होगा उसको. Did you add एडवर्टाइज इन द पेपर सो दैट द ओनर कैन क्लेम द हैट. तो अब पूछता डॉक्टर वॉटसन पूछते हैं कि क्या तुमने कोई एडवर्टीजमेंट नहीं दिया है जिससे इस हैट का ओनर पता चले. तो ही सेज नो. देन हाउ विल यू नो हु द ओनर इज. तो डॉक्टर वॉटसन कहता है जब तुमने एडवर्टीजमेंट नहीं दिया, वेन यू हैव नॉट गिवन द एडवर्टीजमेंट, हाउ विल यू नो दैट इसका ओनर कौन है, हु इज द ओनर ऑफ दिस हैट. ओके, सो नाउ वॉट डिड शर्लॉक होम्स रिप्लाई. शर्लॉक होम्स सेज दैट वी नो वट वी कैन डिड्यूस फ्रॉम दिस हैट, बट यू आर जोकिंग, आई डोंट सी वट यू कैन डिड्यूस फ्रॉम दिस बैटर्ड हैट. सो ही सेज दैट यू जस्ट डोंट वरी, आई विल फाइंड इट आउट हु इज द owner of these two items. I will find it out. And how will I find it out? Because I have my own techniques. Okay, I usually solve these cases, so I am master in this. I am expert in this. I will be able to find the owner of this hat. Okay, so till now we have covered what happened to goose. Goose was cooked by Peterson and hat remained near Sherlock Holmes. Okay, now what happened? See, here is Watson's observation. What happened now? जब इतना discussion होता है तो Sherlock Holmes क्या करता है? Sherlock Holmes hands this hat over to Dr. Watson. वो बोलता है Dr. Watson पहले तुम देखो इस hat को, देख के मुझे बताओ. Tell me the owner. Means can you guess something about the owner of this hat? Okay, so now Dr. Watson is telling us that I took the tattered object. What do you mean by tattered? Tattered means which is not in fine condition. Okay, so he says that I took the tattered object in my hands and turned it over rather ruefully. Means मैंने उसको लिया तो हाथ में, but मैंने बड़ी वैसा बहुत ही खराब सी चीज़ मुझे लगी, तो मैंने उसको बड़ा पिटी तरीके से उसको देखा. It was a very ordinary black hat of the usual round shape, hard and much the worse for wear. What do you mean by much the worse for wear? Means इतनी ज़्यादा वो पहनी हुई hat थी तो वो जो देखने में बहुत पुरानी सी लग रही थी. Okay, the lining had been of red silk और मुझको ये लगा कि उस पर एक red color की lining भी है. Okay, but was a good deal discolored. Means he noticed that there was a red lining, but red lining भी बहुत discolored थी. Means बहुत अच्छा color नहीं दिख रहा था उसमें. There was no maker's name, but as Holmes had remarked, the initials HB were scrawled upon one side. Means he was not able to find that where is the name of that owner of the hat. Okay, but he noticed that two letters are there which were scrawled. I told you the meaning was scrawled. Scrawled means roughly written. तो in the hat securer, means there is an elastic band. In previous time, whenever the people used to wear hats, so there was an elastic band over the hat. Okay, so he says that, see, what we are discussing the observations of Dr. Watson, what he observes about the hat. Okay, so he says that इट वॉज पियर्स इन द ब्रिम फॉर अ हैट सिक्योरर बट द इलास्टिक वॉज मिसिंग. मीन्स हैट पे एक होल था. सी हैट में जो होल होता है बेटा उसी के जरिए वो हैट सिक्योरर लगाया जाता था. ओके सो ही सेज दैट इलास्टिक उसकी मिसिंग थी. मीन्स वो बहुत होल बना हुआ था उसमें बट इलास्टिक वॉज मिसिंग. ओके एंड ही सेज फॉर द रेस्ट इट वॉज क्रैक्ड एक्सीडिंगली डस्टी एंड स्पॉटेड इन सेवरल प्लेसेस ऑल्दो देयर सीम टू हैव बीन सम अटेम्प्ट टू हाइड द डिसकलर्ड पैचेस बाय स्मीयरिंग देम विद इंक. ही सेज दैट आई नोटिस दैट इट वॉज नॉट अ न्यू वन. मीन्स उसका बुराई कर रहा है. डॉक्टर वॉटसन यही सब बता रहा है कि वो डस्टी थी और यू नो बहुत पैचेस लगे हुए थे. सो ये उसके ऑब्जर्वेशन है. ओके सो द क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन मे बी अराउज फ्रॉम हियर दैट व्हाट वर द ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ डॉक्टर वॉटसन अबाउट द हैट. सो दीज वर द ऑब्जर्वेशन. ओके नाउ वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट डिड होम्स से. व्हाट डज होम्स टेल अस अबाउट द कैट अबाउट द हैट. ओके सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द ट्रू ऑब्जर्वेशन बिकॉज एज यू नो दैट डॉक्टर वॉटसन इज नॉट अ डिटेक्टिव. हु इज डिटेक्टिव? शर्लॉक होम्स इज अ डिटेक्टिव. सो नाउ वी विल नोटिस व्हाट आर हिज ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो व्हाट हैपन नाउ सी. नाउ होम्स लुक्ड थॉटफुली एट द हैट एंड सेड The man leads a sedentary life and is quite clever. Now he describes everything, each thing. Okay, he says that जो man है, इस owner का जो man है, the owner leads a sedentary life. Means उसके जो condition है, वो बहुत ही अच्छी नहीं है. Means he is not living very active life and he is quite clever. He is middle aged. And it's not in good physical condition. His hair is grey and puts lime cream in it. He was rich but is now no longer so. Means वो ये सब बताता है कि वो middle age का इंसान है. उसकी physical condition अच्छी नहीं है और वो अपने बालों में lime cream use करता है. वो पहले तो रिच था बट अब रिच नहीं है. ओके ना वो सब ये सब जब ऑब्जर्वेशन डॉक्टर वॉटसन को वो डिस्कस करता है. होम्स हैड अ फ्यू अदर सच डिटेल्स अबाउट द मैन. आई वॉज अस्टाउंडेड. मीन्स वेन डॉक्टर वॉटसन जिस हियर्स दीज ऑल ऑब्जर्वेशन ही सेज दैट आई वॉज अस्टाउंडेड. मीन्स आई वॉज सरप्राइज. मीन्स वेन आई नोटिस्ड आई जस्ट फाउंड दैट इट वॉज अ डस्टी हैट. बट हाउ कैन होम्स फाइंड द गुड ऑब्जर्वेशन? हाउ कैन ही गिव द good observation? So now he was just surprised. So he asked, who asked? Now Dr. Watson asked Sherlock Holmes. He says that I must be very stupid, Holmes, for I am quite unable to follow you. For example, how did you deduce that he is clever from his hat? See, ये जो आपकी line है, this line is asked in your MCQs also. मतलब Dr. Watson says, I must be very stupid, Holmes, for I am quite unable to follow you. मतलब I am stupid, मतलब मैं तो बिल्कुल बेकूफ़ हूँ. मुझे तो ये सब चीज़ें समझ ही में नहीं आई. मुझे तो समझ ही में नहीं आया तुमने ये सब कैसे बोल दिया. I could not understand how your observations are just quite different from my observations. Okay, so he says, well, the hat is, and now he's asked, ki tumne ye sab observations kaise kiya? Tell me some clarification about your observations. Okay, so he says that, well, the hat is very large, so he must have some brains. Now, Sherlock Holmes is giving the, you know, logical explanation that how is he able to find these observations from a single hat. Okay, he says that the hat is very large, so he must have some brains. मतलब उसको देखने में हैट बहुत लार्ज लग रही है. दैट मीन्स उसका ब्रेन्स बहुत बड़ा है, यानी उसके पास कुछ ब्रेन्स है. हाउ डू यू नो ही हैज ग्रे हेयर एंड यूजेस लाइम क्रीम? तुम्हें ये कैसे पता चला कि वो इंसान जो है ग्रे कलर उसके ग्रे हेयर है और वो लाइम क्रीम यूज करता है? सो ही आंसर्स, देयर इज सम फाइन ग्रे हेयर ऑन द लाइनिंग ऑफ द हैट. मैंने जो हैट पे एक लाइनिंग देखी है वो ग्रे कलर की है, वो लाइनिंग उसी से आई है. देयरफॉर हिज हेयर मस्ट बी ग्रे. ओके एंड देयर इज अ फाइन विफ. आई टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ विफ. विफ मीन्स स्मेल. सो और मैंने ये भी नोटिस किया कि उसके बाल उस हार्ट में से लाइम की विफ आ रही है. दैट मीन्स आई गॉट इट दैट ही मस्ट यूज लाइम क्रीम. होम्स हैड अ लॉजिकल एक्सप्लेनेशन फॉर ईच ऑफ हिज डिडक्शंस. नाउ इन ही what did we discuss at this page? We have just discussed what were Watson observations and what were Holmes observations. See you can find a huge difference. Okay, see the video already has taken 15 minutes, so I do not want to lengthen this video. Okay, I think more than half explanation has been done. Some of the explanation is left. We will continue it tomorrow. So till then, stay home, stay safe. Bye bye students, take care.